This is an ESD wristband. None of us want to blow up a board or a chip or even test equipment, which is why these are a staple in any electrically sensitive environment. But honestly, I hate them. So today, I'm going to make them better. I hope. I'm actually pretty terrified to screw this up because I've never worked with anything as fancy as what we're going to work with before. And if I screw it up, it's going to get expensive. But first things first, there are really three things that bother me about these.
There you go, son. I got out of here. You're bothering.
The first is that the cable is simply obnoxious. But unfortunately, we're stuck with the cable. In a previous video, 4 easy ways to blow up your test gear, we tried out and debunked wireless ESD wristbands using a non-contact voltmeter. Even though they may be an excellent Mother's Day gift or anniversary gift, they don't work as ESD bands. I'm really starting to doubt that Amazon description. And unfortunately, we are stuck with a cord. However, there are two things that bother me about these that I think I can fix. First, they aren't very functional. They're only good at the one thing, but they don't really do anything else. Second, they aren't very fashionable. Now, I know that's not the first thing on your mind when you're wearing one of these, but they could at least try a little bit.
If you're gonna build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style?
So let's fix it. We'll divide and conquer and try to improve the functionality problem first. So what's something that's super functional, but also cheap so I can get some practice building my own strap? I feel like it's staring me in the face. That'll do. If this works, it'll tell time and let me do some Ohm's law calculations on the fly. But before we get building, I wanted to interrupt our regularly scheduled program and say that if you haven't checked out Keysight University, you should go and do it now using the link in the description and in the comments. We have tons of free engineering and test gear courses that you can take in under an hour, and you get a certificate of completion for your resume or LinkedIn profile. I've personally put together many of these courses and learned a lot from the ones I didn't create. Go check it out at the link in the description. Also, if you aren't subscribed to this channel, you should be. Where else on YouTube would someone turn a Rolex into an ESD strap? Oop.
Spoilers.
Let's start with the calculator watch. So I think this will be pretty simple. The first thing to do is pull apart an existing ESD strap and see how it works. I'm also hoping to steal the cable and use it too. So first we're gonna measure the resistance of the band and the cable. So you can see the whole system has about a 1 mega ohm resistance. I'm curious also if it's in the strap or in the cable or both, so let's measure them independently. On the strap, I'm seeing anywhere from 0.5 ohm to 2 ohms, so really this is essentially just a short, which means I should see about 1 mega ohm in the cable. So there's our 1 mega ohm. This is actually really exciting because it means we can basically do whatever we want with the watch, and all of the resistance is in the strap. We'll also dig into why it's a 1 mega ohm resistance at the end of the video.
Spoilers.
So what I want to do is take this little snap and solder it somehow to the back of the watch. Conveniently, the back of the watch actually has a metal plate, so it should be fairly straightforward. First though, we have to sacrifice the strap to the ESD gods. Oh my gosh. Goodness, why is it so hard? Oh my goodness. I need some pliers. And I'm sweating.
This will obviously be a montage.
Oh my gosh. Plan B. This one seems a little more fragile. So I think I can flatten this out with a hammer and solder that right to the watch back. Like that. And we'll be in business. Obviously, don't try this at home. Oh yeah. Look at that. Like butter. So this will go in here kind of like that and solder to the metal on the back. And how fashionable is that? Make all the other kids jelly. Because everyone knows I'm the pinnacle of engineering fashion. So we have the watch back, the ESD strap, some flux, some solder paste, a heat gun, and we're gonna make this work.
Moment of truth. I used a Bose compliant solder paste. Oh no.
3 hours later.
So after a fairly prolonged battle with the soldering iron and the heat gun and flux and paste and solder, it turns out it's really hard to solder stainless steel. So we are gonna try out a adhesive epoxy weld approach, and we're gonna see if that works. And if it does, we can call it a victory and move on to our next build. So the first thing we're gonna do is scuff it up a little bit with our rotary tool. Not barehanded. That should help it stick a little bit. And then we're gonna read the directions on the clue.
24 hours later.
So we left this to cure overnight and we haven't tested it at all. So I'm gonna pull it off and we'll see what happens. And that is surprisingly solid. So we'll go ahead and assemble it back up and see what it looks like. So it doesn't look horrible. So that's a check for passable on the street. A little cyberpunk maybe, steampunk. The next test is to actually see if this will work as an ESD band. So I'm gonna hook up the clicker.
Oh no.
So we Dremeled the living daylights out of this poor thing, but it turns out all we had to do was just bend the angle a little bit and then they snap on perfectly. So now all we have to do is test it out and see if it works. To test it out, we're gonna use this ESD tester. You can get them on Amazon, they're like 20 bucks. They're not super expensive, but if you're not grounded, right now I have no ground strap on, and you hit the button, it's gonna send a warning and it's gonna sound horrible. However, if you're tested properly, I have an actual ESD band. The normal ESD band works as expected, no surprises there. The real question is the calculator watch going to work? Okay, even with the angle, still feels pretty good. I can bend my wrist fine, so should be functional for day to day. This thing is basically trash. Add it to our pile of destroyed ESD bands and cables. And now it's time to see if this is actually gonna work. It works! So our beta test is complete. Overall, I would say we learned a lot of ways to not make a wireless ESD band. Less rotary tools, probably better for the future. But we have a functional calculator watch that is also an ESD band. It's still water resistant. Next, we need fashion. I would argue that we have both function and fashion covered with the calculator watch, but some of you more bougie folks might disagree. The fanciest watch I own cost me a whopping two figures, so I set out to find a more fashionable watch. And that means it's story time. I put in a budget request for a used Rolex. This is by far the most ridiculous budget request I've ever submitted. I had to work up the nerve for it and finally hit send on the email at 12:36 a.m. At 7:45 a.m. that same day, I got a response. My boss really didn't have to think too hard on it, but it was worth a shot. After all, now I can say I tried to expense a Rolex to the company. So I had to get more creative and see if I could call in a favor. In another life at Keysight, before I started making videos, I spent a week over in Asia visiting some engineering sites and noticed that the person who hosted me was wearing a pretty fancy watch. That individual has since moved to Colorado Springs, so pre-quarantine, I stopped by his desk to have a chat. And I basically asked him, "Hey David, do you have any ideas for a good watch for this video that we're making?" And I kid you not, the very next day, he walks up knowing what we're doing and he brought me this. And that, my friends, is how you get your hands on a Rolex. Now, if you want to help me prove to my boss that they should have approved that expense request, go sign up for Keysight University at the link in the description. That's how I get to keep making videos like this, and you get to learn something. It's a win-win. I've not actually looked up what this is worth. I'm kind of curious now. Wow. So, I got the calculator watch for about 20 bucks. This is... roughly, if I were to do the math, 20 log, 54 dB more for this watch than this watch. I don't think I've ever measured dollars in dB. Now, I'm honestly pretty terrified to play with this watch, but if it works, it's gonna be legendary. So to do this right, we're gonna have to get fancy. It's not date night, guys. To make this work without wrecking someone else's really nice watch, I picked up a genuine Rolex watch band link to add on. It actually costs more than the calculator watch, and we have to keep it 100% authentic or else it doesn't count. Based on what we learned with the calculator watch, soldering is not gonna work, even though I hoped it would. So we got a different welding glue solution that I think is gonna be a little more solid. We're gonna clamp it up, leave it overnight, and see what happens. I really hope I don't screw this up.
24 hours later.
Okay, this has been sitting for about 24 hours. We're gonna unclamp it, see if we can get it on the strap, and have ourselves a Rolex ESD watch. So let's see how it panned out. Oop, just popped right out. Seems pretty solid. Looks acceptable for today. Let's add it onto the link and see what happens. It's worth more than my car. Really a very simple task, but the stakes are enormous. It looks beautiful. I'm actually really excited. Ooh, oh, it fits. It was a little small before, so adding extra link was actually just right. The funny thing is the calculator watch may end up actually being a better ESD strap than this, but we'll cover that in a minute. I'm gonna cry. No. There's only one thing left to do though. We gotta test it out and see if it works. So here it is with no cable, not touching it. Not good. Let's try it out. Can we get like more dramatic lighting or something just to match how I feel right now? Perfect. All right, here we go. It works. This is officially the world's most expensive ESD strap. Now, I mentioned earlier that the calculator watch might actually be a better strap, and here's why. The standard straps are spec'd to have an internal resistance of less than 100 kilo-ohms so that you get a good connection to your skin. For these builds, I'll just have a good connection already because it's metal and maybe I'll use some lotion or something. But here's where the Rolex is trouble. The external resistance of the band should be greater than 10 mega-ohms so that you don't accidentally short your board or connect to a live circuit if the strap hits it. The calculator watch has a resin strap, so this isn't a problem. But the Rolex is conductive all the way around, which is really not ideal. I'd recommend switching to a nice leather strap or something like that if you were to go into the lab with it. The reason that there's a 1 mega ohm resistance in the cable is that it limits the discharge current. If you come into contact with an energized conductor, you don't want to damage your equipment or yourself. For a normal AC source, like mains voltage, the goal is to keep the current less than half a milliamp. However, this isn't guaranteed protection and you need to make educated safe decisions in the lab. These are all ANSI ESD specifications, so to be safe, always use an approved ESD strap. And that's it for today. Make sure to subscribe to this channel, and if you want more videos like this, let me know in the comments, and go check out Keysight University using the link below. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff. Stay classy, or functional, or both. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.